I offered to let my mom live with me, under the exact same terms I lived with her as a teen. I don't know why in God's good name my mom thought I would be the one to come to, as we don't get along. I went to live with Dad at 16 because she told me she hated me, and then kicked me out. My older brother, the golden child, I know for a fact has a spare bedroom she could sleep in, now that she's losing the house. My mom's situation is entirely her own fault as well, which makes this all the more annoying. She and my stepdad bought a 7-bedroom house 10 years ago, right after she left her job of 20 years to work at some stupid startup that was out of business only 3 years later. My stepdad spent the last years of his miserable life bedbound, because he ignored every doctor telling him to stop shoving his face full of food at every waking moment of the day. So, he died 500 pounds, and in misery. I was more than fine with this, by the way. Well, when he died early this year, it pretty much drained the last of the money my moron of a mother had remaining, and now the bank is taking the house back. So, she shows up at my door for some reason. After mistreating me since I was a kid, and ignoring me unless she wanted something since she married that thankfully dead land whale, she had the nerve to ask to live with me. It's only me and my husband in our 2-bedroom house, sure. But that spare bedroom is his office, the basement is my art studio, and the couch in front of the fireplace is for our lovely cats. There is no room for the wicked hag anywhere in this house. But I knew this opportunity would never come again. So, I told her she could live with us, if, and only if, she decided to follow the house rules. All electronics were to be turned off by 6 p.m. If she was caught with any after that, they would be taken away and sold at the next yard sale. Bedtime was 7:30. If I caught her up, I would take away all of her clothing for the week. She may only shower for 5 minutes, once every 3 days. All chores must be done the moment she wakes up. If I roll out of bed and they are not, she will not be getting meals for the day. She must make sure she is alert at all times. If I and hubby need something done, it is to be done at that moment, or else she will lose her bedding privileges for the night. She will be in charge of cooking one meal each day, that I choose, and if it is not made to my liking, she will not be allowed to join us, and instead will eat the cheapest frozen meal available. I will be reading all her mail, text messages, and emails. I will give her the ones I deem acceptable communication under my roof. Her car will be my own personal travel car. She will also drive me wherever I want. She will still have to pay for gas. And, last but not least, if at any point she displeases me, I will be calling my brother up to pick her up from a nearby gas station. I will get to choose what she takes to put in a torn-up backpack before dropping her off without looking back. She called me a monster, told me these conditions were inhuman, and asked if I was insane. These were the exact conditions I lived under for years as a teenager. The exact conditions she tormented me with for years, until she finally let me go live with the one parent that loved me. And these would be the conditions she would suffer under if she dared to ask me to home her worthless joy-sucking soul. I don't know where she went after she stormed out of my house, but my brother called me and told me that I have the biggest balls in the family for the stunt I pulled. From the sounds of it though, none of the spawn want the broodmother to live with them. I hope she finds a nice park bench to stay on. Now for the comments. Did she recognize those terms, or did you have to remind her where they came from? I'm sure she did. She reveals in the fact she can remember petty arguments and mistakes from 30 years ago. She would never admit to it though, because that would prove that she was always a horrible mother in person. Parents like this always acknowledge what they did, but then follow up with some BS like, I did it because I care, and you're too selfish to see how much I love you. Gaslighting at its core. I wish my stepdad had said the reason I was treated horribly was because I was never good enough for basic decency. They straight up didn't like me, no excuses besides that. Savage, 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 like holy smokes. Poor you. As a mother, I don't see any benefits from those rules for my children. Hope you had some therapy after, and I hope you know that that's not okay. You're awesome for telling your mom those rules. Not cruel in a single way. I love it. Your house sounds cozy. I've talked a few therapists' ears off over the years, lol. I lived with my dad for 4 years after I left hell on earth. It was a night and day difference. There is no reality that treating a child like that is okay. But it's okay to taunt a monster at her lowest, in my opinion. Well, sounds like she got what she deserved. 20 years ago, I had just gotten married. My wife and I went to stay at her sister's place for a week. They insisted we stay in separate bedrooms. My wife told me quietly that they were worried we might be intimate in our room otherwise. A couple of years later, they wanted to come and stay in our place for a week. We had bought a place in the city. I said sure, no problem, but they must stay in separate bedrooms. They were outraged. My wife asked me to please let them stay in one, but I refused, and they chose not to stay with us. I approve of your choice. Please tell me you reminded them of when they treated you like children, lol. No, but I reminded my wife, and I am sure they got the message. Jesus, they perpetuate the issue by not recognizing, acknowledging, and apologizing for their ridiculous behavior when they made that request of you originally. If they simply got to the, I'm sorry, that was dumb, then I'm sure you'd let them stay in your spare bedroom and everyone could leave this in the past. What babies? Maybe next time. You're right. If they'd have apologized, I would have let bygones be bygones. Everyone makes mistakes. But getting all iffy about it confirmed that they thought it should be one standard for us and another standard for them. F that. Next story. Update. The man baby is finally facing the music. Original post. My brother is 31 years old. In his time on Earth, he has not had to lift a finger to keep any of his needs met. He dropped out of college after less than half a semester because he could not bother rolling out of bed before noon to take the car our parents got him to class. He's worked a combination of 2.5 months in his entire life. He lost his first job at a Dairy Queen because he swore at a mother over the drive-thru speakers, and lost his second because he got caught stealing from the till of a family-owned restaurant. He has spent the last 8 years rolling out of bed at 2 p.m. to do nothing but play video games and troll Discord servers to find someone just as pathetic as him to hang out with. It does not help that he's an annoying, violent, self-centered brat who would push my parents in front of a bus for the thrill of the dopamine hit. My parents always tried their best with us. They gave us everything we ever needed in life and then some. They have always been more than understanding to all of their children. For me and my 2 siblings who are worth something, it led to incredible performances in academia, well-paying jobs, and an amazing start to our adult lives. I wish I could commend them for the 75% success rate, but they have allowed the man baby to sit in his cradle and make demands for 31 years too long. And now, they find themselves with an overgrown toddler who sits in the attic, playing Valorant all day, while cursing my mom out when she dares to ask him to clean up the rotting garbage he spreads across his room. Last year, Dad had a stroke, and he is now at a point where he needs 24-hour care from a professional. My mother is burned out. She retired when Dad had the stroke to take care of him, and it's done more damage to their relationship than 33 years of marriage could ever do. It does not help that they are perpetually harassed by the child, demanding his dinner be delivered to him, while he screams at teenagers over the internet. Me, all my human siblings, and my parents have been talking for months now about solutions. At the beginning of the month, we decided Dad is going to a care center. Mom will sell the house to move to a 55-plus community close to Dad, and the man baby will hopefully find a box with an internet connection. Mom and Dad have always protected him, but my guess is the stroke finally woke them up to the reality of the situation. Yeah, it sucks, and they are to blame for allowing him to get to this point. But there comes a time to cut your losses and admit you messed up and move on. It's a shame that all of the man baby's siblings, including myself, hate his guts. None of us care what happens to him, and it's interesting to say that out loud, now that I think about it. I got the privilege to be there yesterday when he got the news. Mom's going to be moving in with sis till the house sells, Dad's going to the care center next week, and movers will be clearing the place out starting pretty much now. He has a month, and the eviction process is already rolling. The non-emergency line already knows that his temperamental and violent behind has been served, and is ready to respond if he does something stupid. Oh, and our firefighter neighbor will be over in only a few minutes if he needs himself put in gear on short notice. It was wonderful. His meltdown was legendary. He actually stomped his feet and screamed that it's not fair, said he was going to sue us all, screamed in an elderly man's face saying he wants to kick his butt. He demanded to know what we were going to do to help him find a place to live, how much money we were going to give him to make sure he didn't end up on the streets, asked what he's supposed to do about the fact he was saving his money to buy a new graphics card. He somehow still does not understand exactly what he is now facing. He's now not talking to mom or dad, he's locked himself in his room since last night, and only comes out to use the restroom and take food from the pantry that will not be filling itself anymore. It's great as my brother is staying there and working remotely to make sure he does not try anything and to update me and my sister on the man baby's tantrum. I'm looking forward to the next month. It will be the best reality television I've seen in a while. Now for the top comments before reading the updates. Sounds like my uncle. He told us he's waiting for my grandparents to die so he can keep the house. Joke's on him though, because my grandparents will, says the house is going to my mom. That was my uncle. He was furious when he found out that my grandmother not only deeded the house and property to my mom, who has now deeded it to me 20 years later, but that my mom was now her financial, legal, and medical power of attorney and the gravy train had ended. He tried to scream about suing her. Mom simply told him she would see him in court over the fraud he committed in Granny's name. That shut him up. How can someone hope that a loved one will die just so that they inherit something? How do they not see this as disgusting and abhorrent behavior? Some people will even kill for it, such as the case of Joel and Lisa Guy, who were unalived by their adult baby son when they decided to retire early and stop providing money to him. OP's parents should be very, very cautious during this time. They are in a harmful, trauma-bonded relationship with a toxic person, even though it's their own son. And just as in any harmful relationship, when one threatens to leave, that's when the violence happens. Please keep us updated. I had a sibling like this, and when my mom finally put her foot down and said no more, it was the best thing in the world for him. He got off his butt and became a functioning member of society. I hope the same happens for your family. I wish my mom would say no more to my sister. She just keeps getting taken advantage of. Recently, my mom vented to my sister that she was annoyed, and my sister said she was done with her. After my mom let her move back in, and has lent her approximately $4,000 and co-signed on her car that she doesn't pay on time. Not to mention she watches her kid for her all the time, because she leaves them home alone to go out all the time. We're all fed up. She is extremely entitled and ungrateful. Why are people like this? I'm the oldest sibling, and I have a brother who's always lived off my parents. Please promise to update us because I know there has to be so many others in this situation. Kinda why I came here to be honest with you. I've been waiting so long for the pin to drop about this. Others deserve to share the good news. Quick update. The man baby has not gotten violent, luckily. He has made everyone's life a living hell, however. He says he's found a place to live though, and says he'll be out by the end of the month. Now for the full update. Hello again everyone. I never expected my last post to get popular, but it was a pleasant surprise. Anyways, here's the update. So, after where my original post left off, not much happened at first. The man baby sulked and gave my parents the silent treatment until both of them moved out of the house. He had a bit of a tantrum when he realized that my brother would not be buying groceries for him, and he would, gasp, have to spend his computer fund to feed himself. After mom moved out, I think that's when it hit him that this was happening, and no amount of sulking and complaining would stop the eviction date from coming any closer. He had a massive tantrum a few nights after mom moved out. He blew up the family group chat demanding we help him find a place to live and give him money for a deposit. I responded with a gif of a laughing cat, and my sister blocked his number. He and our brother got into a fight, but like I always thought, he was too cowardly to actually do anything, so he sulked to his room. Skipping every little petty and childish thing he did over the month, he in the end did find a place to actually live. He started to do Uber to make some cash while he claims to look for a job. We'll see how that turns out. Anyway, from what I understand, he knows someone locally that he plays video games with, and the guy hooked him up with a cheap place to live. And when I say cheap, I mean cheap. I ended up offering to help the man baby move to his new place, and got a first-hand look at the crack house he's now living at. He's living in a room above the garage, in a three-bedroom, rundown crack house straight out of Compton. The place has fiber internet though, which was the must-have feature for my brother apparently. I didn't get a single thanks for helping him move, and he demanded I buy him lunch afterward. I left him hungry. Anyways, we'll see how long this lasts, as the man baby still seems to insist on not getting an actual job, and thinks that if he begs me and my family for money, he'll get by. He apparently has already nearly depleted his graphics card fund, and is blowing my mom up asking for $1,000, so it seems to be going well for him. He did ask me for money when I was helping him move, and I told him that McDonald's is always hiring. He scoffed and told me he was too good for that. I guess we'll see how long that lasts. Anyways, the man baby has left the building. Too good for McDonald's, lol. Has a total of 2.5 months of work under his 31-year-old belt. McDonald's might be too good for him. As a 34-year-old with absolutely no motivation, serious mental health issues, and a family to feed, fast food employment has been my saving grace. I will forever be grateful for a job, any job, that pays enough to survive. It sounds like you've got some motivation, my friend. You show good character. Many years I've been there, offered shift supervisor and assistant manager roles, refused them all. I'm happy being a little nobody on the line. It's enough. I, 33 female, often feel like a failure because my older brother is married with a house and my younger sister graduated college and traveled to exotic places. Meanwhile, I have no health insurance and can't bring myself to cut weed out of my household budget. Then I read about people like this and realize I'm pretty damn all right. I've paid my own rent for years and didn't really need significant help until these last few months. And even when I go running to mommy and daddy for help, I've still got the decency to realize what a gift that kind of support is, lol. I'm 31 and feel very similarly to you. No health insurance and an expensive habit. But look at us, paying rent, holding jobs, not being terrible,